Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video we are going to see a different types of memory inside the microcontroller. So if you see any modern day microcontroller, let us take an example of a very popular Arduino based microcontroller board or very advanced Cortex M4 based any microcontroller. So if you see the specs of this microcontroller, you will find three different types of memory. So if you see these microcontrollers, you will find three types of memories. The first is the flash memory, second is the SRAM, and third is the EEPROM. Now some of you might have a question in your mind that which memory is used as a program memory and which memory is used as a data memory. So let's find out in this video that what is the purpose of all the three memories and which memory is used as a program memory and which memory is used as a data memory. So as I said earlier, the microcontroller have two types of memory. The one is the program memory and second is the data memory. Now the most of the microcontrollers which we see today are based on the Harvard architecture, and in this architecture the program memory and data memory are separate memories. Now this program memory has to be a non-volatile kind of memory. The reason is that even if the power goes down or if you reset the microcontroller, then the code which is written inside this microcontroller should not get lost, while the data memory can be a volatile or a non-volatile. So now if you see the today's microcontroller, in today's microcontroller the flash memory is used as a program memory, while as a data memory two types of memories are used, SRAM and the EEPROM. So now let's find out in this video that why this flash memory is used as a program memory and other memories are used as a data memory. So first of all, let us see the program memory inside the microcontroller. So now before we see about this flash memory, let us see the evolution of the program memory inside this microcontroller. So in early days, this read-only memory or a ROM was used as a program memory inside the microcontroller. Now this read-only memory or a ROM is a one-time programmable memory. That means during the time of a production itself, this memory is getting programmed. But once it has been programmed, you cannot change the content inside this memory. Then came the second type of memory, which is known as a programmable ROM or a PROM. Now this PROM or a programmable ROM is also a one-time programmable memory, but user can program this memory using a programmer. But once it has been programmed, you cannot change the content of this PROM. Now as the technology evolved, the third kind of memory came into the market, which is known as the EEPROM. Now this EEPROM, as its name suggests, it is a erasable and the programmable ROM, and we can erase the content of this EEPROM using the special UV rays. Now to erase the content of this EEPROM, the small quartz window on top of this EEPROM was given. So using the UV rays we can erase the content of this programmable ROM and we can rewrite the program again inside this EEPROM. So then after, the fourth kind of memory came into the market, which is known as the EEPROM. That is electrically erasable and a programmable ROM. So now unlike EEPROM, we can erase the content of this EEPROM using electrical voltages. So now in this EEPROM, if you see, it is possible to read, write or erase a one particular byte or one particular word of data at a time. So after this EEPROM, then came the flash memory. So this flash memory is a subset of this EEPROM, or we can say that it is a one type of EEPROM. Now in case of a flash memory, unlike the EEPROM, we can erase the entire block of data at a same time. And in this flash memory, there are two types of memory available, the NAND flash and the NOR flash. So in case of a NAND flash, even reading and writing is also performed in a blocks. But in case of a NOR flash, it is possible to read or write one particular word or one particular byte of data at a time, but the erase operation is performed on an entire block. So this NOR flash is used as a program memory inside this microcontroller, and there are many reasons for using this flash memory as a program memory inside the microcontroller. The first reason is its high density. So in case of a flash memory, in a same area we can accommodate more number of memory cells, or to accommodate the same number of memory cells we require a less amount of die area. That is one of the reasons why this flash memory is used as a program memory. The second reason for using this flash memory as a program memory is its fast reading time. So this flash memory and particularly this NOR flash provides a very good read times. So using this flash memory, we can execute our program very fast. So the only problem with this flash memory is its endurance or a life cycle. So the number of write or erase operations which can be performed on this flash memory is quite limited. So we can write or erase this flash memory only 10,000 times. But now as the technology evolved, Now it is possible to erase or rewrite this flash memory as many as 100k times. But if you see the EEPROM, the life cycle of this EEPROM is in the range of 100k up to the 500k. So the number of write or erase operations can be performed on the EEPROM is much more compared to this flash memory. So these are the some of the reasons why this flash memory is used as a program memory inside the microcontroller. Now let us see the data memory inside this microcontroller. So as we have discussed earlier, there are two types of data memory inside the microcontroller, the SRAM and the EEPROM. So first let us talk about this SRAM. So in this static RAM, the each memory cell consists of 6 transistors, and out of these 6 transistors, the 4 transistors are used to store the data and the 2 transistors are used for the control purpose. So we will understand this SRAM in detail in the separate video. And the reason for using this static RAM as a data memory is its fast read and write speed. In fact, if you see the static RAM or SRAM, it is fastest among all the available memories today. And that is the reason not only in the microcontrollers but in computers also this SRAM is used as a cache memory. But this static RAM is a volatile kind of memory. That means once the power goes off, all the content inside this SRAM also gets lost. And that is where this EEPROM is quite helpful, because this EEPROM is a non-volatile kind of memory. That means we can store a important data inside this EEPROM. So if you want to store the data which is coming from the sensor, or if you want to store the some status variables, then you can use this EEPROM. So this is all about the different types of memory inside the microcontroller. So in a summary, if you see, there are three types of memory inside the microcontroller: the flash memory, the SRAM and the EEPROM. So this flash memory is used as a program memory, and this SRAM and EEPROM are used as a data memory inside this microcontroller. So I hope in this video you understood about the different types of memory inside the microcontroller. If you have any question or suggestion, please let me know in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.